Daylily rust is a fungus disease that attacks our daylilies. And this particular disease actually is a rust disease that's wind-borne by nature. The fungus produces very lightweight spores that can travel wind currents for several hundreds of miles. The disease usually appears initially on the upper leaf surface, followed by infection on the lower leaf surface. The classic symptoms are small, raised, pimple-like pustules that develop on the leaves. And these are usually yellow or bright orange in color. Also, the scape or the flower stalk of the plant can show these particular symptoms. Now, one easy test that the homeowner can use to help give them a clue as to whether or not they actually have the rust disease on their daylilies is by doing a simple tissue test, as we call it. By that, I'm referring to taking a piece of white tissue paper and gently wiping some of these suspect leaves. If a yellow smudge comes off on the white paper, then that's usually a good clue that there actually may be a rust infection there. But ultimately, the most accurate way is to submit suspect plant tissue through the local extension office and on to the plant health clinic at Lone Oak for confirmation of the disease. We feel like probably the best way for the homeowner to control this disease is growing resistant varieties. There are fungicides that are available, but growing resistant varieties will probably be the most economical way to control this disease. Now, Dr. Jim Robbins, our extension horticulturist, and myself have rated over 400 cultivars of daylilies to their reaction to this particular disease. And this list is available on our extension website for growers who want to find out which cultivars develop the disease less than others. So this is an excellent resource. There's also a daylily fact sheet available through your local extension office by the number FSA 7525. And there's a wealth of information about this disease and actually some very nice photographs on what this disease looks like on the plant.
To learn more, contact your county extension agent and follow the links in this section.